All Muslims in the world believe in the existence and oneness of God, in the angels, the divine books, the prophets, and the hereafter, and all share common values. One of the most important of these values that draw believers close to one another and weld them together is the sacred sites in which the name of God is praised, mosques. Three great mosques occupy an important place in the history of Islam. The Great Mosque around the Holy Kaaba in Mecca, the Al-Aqsa Mosque in Jerusalem, and the Prophet's Mosque in Medina. These three great mosques have played host to very important events in the history of Islam. By visiting these mosques and the holy lands around them, Muslims' fervor and enthusiasm rises, their public spiritedness grows, their bonds of brotherhood are strengthened, and these sites are instrumental in bringing them closer to Almighty God. Let us now look at the history and features of these three sacred sites. The Masjid al-Haram, or the Great Mosque in the city of Mecca and the Kaaba inside it, is the common site towards which all Muslims face when praying, and one of the most important sites in Islam. Mecca is described as the mother of cities in the Quran. The Kaaba and the Great Mosque around it are in the center of the city. The term, meaning the sacred mosque, appears in 16 verses of the Quran. One of these verses reads, "Wherever you come from, turn your face to the Masjid al-Haram. This is certainly the truth from your Lord. God is not unaware of what you do." As well as the Kaaba, the Great Mosque also houses the Station of Abraham and the Well of Zamzam. Immediately beside it stand the hills Safa and Marwa. In the days of the Prophet, may God bless him and grant him peace, the Great Mosque occupied a small area around the Kaaba, but has been extended many times up to the present day. Today, the Great Mosque is large enough to allow hundreds of thousands of people to pray together. The Kaaba, the holiest site on earth for Muslims, was constructed at Almighty God's command by the Prophet Abraham and his son, the Prophet Ishmael, peace be upon them both. God reveals that the station of the Prophet Abraham stands within the Kaaba, the first house built for people. In it are clear signs, the station of Abraham. All who enter it are safe. Hajj to the house is a duty owed to God by all mankind, those who can find a way to do it. But if anyone is unbeliever, God is rich beyond need of any being. God commanded the Prophet Abraham to call people to come as pilgrims to the Kaaba. From that time on, believers have visited the Kaaba in vast numbers to perform their Hajj obligations. This is described in verses. Announce the Hajj to mankind. They will come to you on foot and on every sort of lean animal, coming by every distant road so that they can be present at what will profit them and invoke God's name on specific days over livestock He has provided for them. Eat of them and feed those who are poor and in need. In the Quran, God reveals that the Kaaba will have a most important impact on people. The expression, so that they can be present at what will profit them, in the verse makes this very clear. Ever since the time of the Prophet Abraham, the Kaaba has been an important site visited by Muslims on the Hajj.